Now I'm going to talk a little bit about the solution inspector. The solution inspector is a new feature in the DWSIM 5.2. It shows the details of internal calculations in a human readable report, including all relevant data manipulation as described by the thermal and unit operation models. Okay? With the solution inspector, you can discover how properties are calculated and check where the data comes from. Okay, it's like you're reading a thermal book, but using the data actually calculated in the flowsheet. So let's load a sample so I can show you how it works. Let me open, for instance, the liquid. No, this sample is too advanced for this course. Let me show you. Heat exchanger. To enable the solution inspector reports, you should go to Edit, General Settings, and in the Solver tab you must enable the Inspector Reports feature. Okay, and each time you send a command to solve the flowsheet, the DWSIM will record a report for each material stream and each energy stream and unit operation in the flowsheet. So when you go to Tools and Solution Inspector, you will see a list of available solution report sets. Each ID here is the time that you've sent the solve command to the flowsheet solver. Okay, so when you click on the report set, the solution inspector will load the reports. You can see that there is a lot of reports because every calculation is... DWSIM creates a report for each calculation, each individual calculation. So here are the reports for this solving session. You can see that here is a report for the solver call. You can see the list of the objects to be calculated, and they were calculated in this order. You have some details about the calculation, and if you click on the other reports, you will see, for instance, this is the report for the calculation of the gasoline material stream. You will see what you've specified, what the DWSIM used to calculate the stream. And if you click on the plus button, you will see the phase equilibria calculation. It uses the nested loops VLE flash algorithm. And you can see the model details, the input parameters, what were the final converged values for the K values, and you can see all the routines and the calculations that were done inside each item, each report. You can see that the nested loops flash converted in two iterations, so here you can have the details for each iteration. The error for the vapor fraction at the end of this iteration, the second one, you had -1.0, which is a sign that the stream is all liquid. You can see that this iteration called the K-value calculation from the Peng-Robinson equation of state.
and the k-value is calculated using the fugacity coefficients. So here are the reports for these calls. You can see all the details here, what were the input parameters, the calculated intermediate parameters, and the results of this calculation. Inside this fugacity coefficient, you can see that here is another report for the compressibility factor calculation using the equation of state. This is the compressibility for a liquid phase, as you can see. And there are a lot of other reports. Here you can see the Le-Kessler enthalpy equations, the results, the details for this calculation, the heat exchanger itself. You can see how it was calculated, the theory behind the calculation mode, details about the maximum heat exchange that was calculated, initial estimates for the Sheldon tube calculation method, how many loops it converged. You will see all the results for each loop. You can see that it converged after 36 iterations. And here are the values of the parameters, the error of the temperature, and the final results for this calculation of the heat exchanger. Okay, and the heat exchanger itself calls a lot of internal routines for phase equilibria. It creates a temporary material stream in order to calculate the fluid properties, and you can see all the calculation results here too. Okay, so you can see the complexity of a process simulator calculation through the solution inspector. Okay, so that's it. Thank you.